It's not one of those videos where I can just tell you everything I'm going to do and you go do it and it works out for you. Like I said, this is me doing my trial and error and bringing you guys along with me, because one thing about me and my content creation journey, influencer journey, whatever you want to call it, I am always going to be real and raw. I know if you got a girl, don't mean to disrespect, but I love you, rule my world. I even dream of you, I swear. Visions of you and I. Hey guys, it's Kiala K. Welcome to my channel, or if you're a returning subscriber, welcome back. As you can tell by today's title, we are doing a chit chat. I'm going to be giving you guys tips on the modeling industry, influencer, content creator industry, basically the entertainment industry as a whole. If you guys watched the video that I will go ahead and put in a card up there, I have been in the entertainment industry. I've been in music videos, TV shows, movies, commercials. I actually just did a, I did a Ciroc commercial. And I always get people DMing me or asking me like, how did you get into that? Because they want tips on how to get into it. And I just decided, instead of writing everybody back, just make a video so everybody can stop asking me questions. I'm going to answer literally everything. This is going to be the most detailed video that I've ever done. I've been in the whole content creator business, I would say, since 2019 when I first made my YouTube channel. It's not this channel. My channel actually got deleted, but you guys can click the card up there and watch that video to see why my channel got deleted. So I have to start all over. I was so close to being monetized. So close, I almost wanted to just give up and not do YouTube anymore, but I decided to stick it out. And so, new channel, same me. So let's get into the video. So when it comes to being a model, like I said in the previous video, I would say that getting a manager is the best way. The easiest, simple answer is to get a manager. They can go ahead and submit you to anything. They can give you all the submissions that you probably can find if you do some searching, but if you don't feel like doing searching, like I don't feel like doing searching, which is why I got a manager. They can literally send you all the submissions in your city, state, and let you decide what you want to go to. That way you're never like out the loop or anything. Some people don't want to get a manager because they don't want to pay somebody else, which is completely understandable. There, like I said, that's not the only option. There is ways for you to get into this business, into the music videos and TV shows, etc., without having a model, without having a manager. I would just say having a manager makes things 10 times easier, and it takes less stress off of your back than you going to have to search. They literally just come to you. But if you don't want to get a manager, you can also just follow all the casting pages on Instagram. They post their castings every single day. Like, I literally can't scroll through Instagram without seeing a casting. So you never can say that you're not booked and busy if you don't want to be. Like, for example, if I'm not booked for something a day, it's because I didn't submit and I didn't try. That sounded really cocky. If you want to do something every single day, you have the option to work every single day and make it your full-time job. Casting directors that I would say to follow, if you are in LA, Miami, the Bay Area, I would say follow Milltick Entertainment. He's based out of LA, but he does have castings in Atlanta, LA, Miami. He actually booked me for the P. Diddy Ciroc commercial. He booked my friend for the No Guidance with Chris Brown and Drake. He also booked this girl I know for Chris Brown and Christian Combs' video, and for one of Cardi B's videos. Like, he works with high end. He books what I know for a freaking Polo G video too. Like, he has very high end clients. He is, like I said, based out of LA. So if you're in California, if you don't follow him and you're trying to get into business, you're not serious about your craft at all, like at all. He also does have really good castings in Atlanta and Miami as well, I can vouch. If you're in Atlanta, some ones I would say follow are Casting Plug. He has a lot in Atlanta. Almost every day he's casting for something in Atlanta, both like high-end celebrities and like low-end new celebrities. ATL Talent, invited from him to Metro Boomin's birthday party, 21 Savage birthday party, Mulatto's birthday party. So when it comes to like parties and stuff like that, I know he did Young Thug's birthday party. He's supposed to be doing Kodak's birthday party. He did something else for Mulatto like 2 weeks ago, I think. For parties, he's the person to go to. Also, if you're in LA, Milltick Entertainment also does parties. They just went to Christian Combs' 90s theme birthday party. So if you don't, like, you know, if you don't want to be in music videos, that's not your thing, but you still want to be into the entertainment business, entertainment industry, go to parties, you can mingle, meet people. I saw emails that Cardi B's party. It's different ways for you to tap into the industry without, because, you know, music videos aren't really for everybody. Like, I know personally, music videos, it's like, it depends on what video it is, because when it comes to like twerking and stuff, I prefer not to do that. If a theme is like, you know, a party or something, I'm with like some girls, like having fun, turning up, that's different than me having to actually like twerk on a celebrity or like twerk for the camera. Like, that's just not me. That's just not me. SK Agency is also another one in Atlanta. She does a lot of music videos. She booked me for 2 Chainz and Moneybagg Yo. She has a lot of bookings for Nakia. Like, she always books for Nakia. In Miami, there's so many that I follow here. I literally cannot think off the top of my head. There's Jay Duchess. There's United Miami. If I'm saying these name wrongs, I'm sorry. They will also be in the description. I just can't think. There's so many in Miami. Like I said, if you do want to get into the more the music videos and parties, celebrity parties and stuff, I would definitely say you need to do a photo shoot at least once a month. And at least switch up the styles. So like, switch up your hairstyles. I was supposed to do a video for Kodak Black and Jason Derulo last week. I submitted my pictures. I had curly hair. Obviously I have braids, and now they were like, that's fine, just send me a picture with you with the braids. But, you know, I wanted to, like, you know, put on makeup and send a picture, but I never got around to doing it. I never sent the pictures because I didn't feel like getting dressed to just take a picture. I just really didn't feel like it, so I just told them to go on with somebody else for that gig. And, you know, if I had pictures with me with braids, it would have been easier, would have been better. So I would say always do pictures, different looks, different hairstyles. I do lingerie. Lingerie and bikini are very, very, very key if you want to be in music videos. Make sure you have a wide variety. Make sure you have a lot of pictures to send, because I obviously can't talk right now. So I would also say make sure you have a comp card. A comp card is basically your about me in a flyer form. So it has pictures, your height, your age, weight, name, stuff like that. So like I said, you're about me in flyer form. My manager put up a casting for Atlanta for, she just said, somebody's clothing line. So all she said, somebody's clothing line. So people submitted in Atlanta. The girl who got picked actually was part of my agency, and she said she got picked because they told her she got picked because she is the only model who had a comp card. Actually was for Jada Weta's brand. The comp cards make you look more serious, like you're more about your actions, what you actually want to do. So her having a comp card is like, not saying it's the only reason she got picked, but it helped her get picked because she looked more serious. She presented herself better than the other models than who just submitted pictures. Some apps that I would say I would use for castings for like everything, any casting you want, I would say use Project Casting. You make your profile, it has a billboard, like a jobs section, it has all the listings. Another website you can use is Casting Networks. It's just like Project Casting. You make your profile, you have all the jobs that you can submit for. They literally just had one in Ohio for LeBron James. He's doing a movie. They had Wild and Out Girls they were casting on there. They have a variety of things. There's free version and there's non-free versions. Of course, if you pay, you get to submit to unlimited castings. The free version, you're very like selected, you get a minimum amount you could submit to a month. I think for Project Casting, I have the free version, and for Casting Networks, I pay like $25 a month, but I think it's worth it because you literally can submit to unlimited things. There's always something. Like, there's no reason for you to not be booked and busy if you really want to be. So disclaimer, so I am 100% not a content creator who has lots of followers and doing all these brands and making thousands of dollars. This is me bringing you guys along my journey of me just starting out and the errors and mistakes and things that I know that I can help you guys not make the same mistakes that I did, or just help you guys get started. Because 100 YouTube videos about how and TikTok about how to do stuff, but I feel like people who make those videos already are established. Like, they already have their hundreds and thousands of followers, they already have their brand deals and making thousands of dollars. Whereas me, I am just starting out like you guys. I'm giving you guys the real, uncut, raw truth about the steps to becoming a content creator, influencer. It's not going to be peaches and cream. All right, so the reason why I feel like most of you guys are here, which is something that's been more popular now. I feel like TikTok has made it way more popular. I see it all down my For You page. It's like the content creation influencer. Content creation is taking over, really taking over right now. So like I said, I've been a content creator, I would say, since 2019 when I started my YouTube channel, but I feel like I could be way further if I knew then what I know now when it comes to content creation, because it's a whole new world. People are literally quitting their 9-to-5 jobs and just being a full-time content creator, and they're making bank. Like, they're making more than people make. People are making 6 figures off of content creation. 6 figures. And people think it's so easy to just record a video. Like, no, content creators, I salute myself, I salute y'all, because it is a full-time job. Having to record, edit, reach out to brands, make sure everything, the brand right now, rip you off. Like, also, I don't have a manager from my content creator side. People do have managers for that. Hopefully soon, as I get deeper into content creation, I'll be able to get a manager, but right now I don't have one. So if you guys know any managers that work with micro influencers, let me know. I'm a very small channel right now, just now starting content creation, trying to take that more seriously, and hopefully I can quit my job and just be a full-time content creator and a full-time realtor and live my life how I want to live my life. Content creator, I would say the number, like, a big thing with content creation is, or a big thing with being an influencer, is keeping up with trends but making it your own, making it different. So I scroll through TikTok and see 1,000 of the same videos, like content creation, like tips and everything, but like people put their own personality into it. Like, even with YouTube, you can have a million cleaning videos. Like, I scroll down to see clean with me, shower routines, vlogs, but everybody has their own spin to it, their own personality into it. That's what makes you want to watch that person, subscribe, follow that person, is their personality. Personality sells. If you're doing the same thing another channel is doing, why would I follow? Like, I don't have to follow you. I could just follow the other channel. You have to stick out. That's the key point that I feel like a lot of people are missing right now, is they're trying to, everybody wants to be a content creator right now. So they're just trying to see what other people are doing. Like, okay, she did this and she went viral off of this. Let me go do this. If you're not guaranteed to go viral because you did the same thing as somebody else did. You have to put your own, like, make me want to follow you. Posting frequently, posting consistently. Like, my goal is to be able to post 3 times a week. That is my goal. If I could post a vlog on Sunday, a sit down video on Tuesday, another video on Thursday, like, I would be content. I have to just push myself to get there. So posting frequently and consistently is only going to help. Like, if you don't, like, I know that my channel isn't where my old channel was, because my old channel, I posted at least once or twice a week. Like, I was on top of my game. I always posted, I always had videos to edit. Now I post sporadically, like when I go somewhere or when something pops up, but like, I literally have a list. I have a full notes list of ideas to post for YouTube, and I just haven't done them. And the reason I feel like I haven't done I have a lot of sit down videos or like at home videos that, or like even shower routine stuff that I want to post, but I'm not in my own apartment where things are decorated and, you know, everything's nice, as you can see in this bland room. Like, hopefully soon I will be getting to my own apartment so you guys will see all of that, and then I'll feel more comfortable posting, because, like, I'm not even gonna lie, I like aesthetics. I like aesthetic things that are aesthetically pleasing. So like the nice showers, the nice shower heads, like, you know, recording the soap with the marble shower, like, even having a record, like, my apartment, I'm gonna have my own section for me to film YouTube videos. I'm going to, like, I like aesthetics. Having aesthetically pleasing place to record makes me not want to record. It sounds stupid, it may be, but to me it doesn't. Make sure you post frequently, consistently. Batch create, if you guys don't know what that is, it's when you have a day where you push content out. You just record content. You record. You could change outfits, you could change hairstyles, just make that whole time period or that whole day just you recording. You're on a plane, you're getting ready to go on a trip, you haven't posted in 2 days or anything. bam, you had an old video you recorded, never posted, including your batch creation day, boom, go and post that. So batch creation is key because you make sure you always have something to post. You're always keeping it, you're always being engaged. So TikTok has definitely taken over for content creation, influencing right now. It has 100% taken over. I feel like TikTok made me want to start taking content creation more seriously. Like, you know, you scroll through your TikTok, people are posting how much they made in a week or a month and how many brands reached out to them. And it's just like, damn, like, that could be me. Like, I'm not even gonna hold y'all. I'm about to humble brag. If I had my old channel, I still had all my followers and my watch hours, and I know right now I'd be monetized. I would have been monetized. I would be on y'all's neck when it comes to this content creator stuff. I know I would. And not saying just like monetary wise, like not saying just money wise, like being consistent, it would make me want to continue being consistent. Like seeing me grow, seeing my, like, I'm not even gonna lie, the reason I don't record and don't post as much now is because it's like my channel is a small channel. Like, I don't see my channel growing. Like, I'm not even gonna lie, for me just not posting a lot and starting the channel over, I have a very good following right now. Like, I'm good. But it's not where I was. Like, I was close to monetization. So it's like, discouragement is kind of what I'm in right now. But I know that, again, it's like I'm contradicting myself, because I know if I did post more consistently, I could get back to where I was. So I just started posting a lot on TikTok. And when it comes to TikTok, I would say that when I first started posting, I was utilizing hashtags a lot. Like, I was probably using hashtags way too much. My videos weren't going anywhere. So like, people were saying, let's use your niche hashtags. Those still weren't even working for me. When I post a video without hashtags, it does way better than me posting videos with hashtags. I don't know why. That's just me personally. And I saw a video on my TikTok For You page, somebody else saying this, that non-hashtags work better than, not using hashtags work better than using hashtags. And I even uploaded a video using hashtags one time, and it got like 3 views within like 40 minutes. I deleted it, re-uploaded it without hashtags, and it had like 278 within like 30 something minutes. Figure out what works for you. Like I said, for me, hashtags just don't work. Figure out what works for you. When it comes to me, like a content creator, I was saying having friends that are on the same exact like wavelength that also are into content creation really does help, because it's like you can have like content creation dates. So like, for example, like when you go out with friends and you're, who aren't into content creation, you're sitting there like trying to record everything or like make sure everything is aesthetically pleasing to them, they don't get it. It's just like, girl, you're doing too much. But if you have a friend who is like, they get you, they're into it too. It's like they can make sure things are in place. They know, like, they see things through your eyes. So it's like they know how to do things, how to move. Like when it comes to taking pictures, dog. Come taking pictures. Friends who don't take content creation seriously or don't take influencing seriously, to them a picture is a picture. They can snap a picture, have it all types of weird angles, don't care. They don't get the background right, or they just take pictures stupid. Friends who are in the same mindset as you, they know like what angles and what backgrounds to get and stuff like that. Just having a content creation friend is definitely makes things easier in this lifestyle. Be tripod. Like, I'm not even gonna hold you, tripod. If you feel like your friends don't get you, they don't get your vibe, they can't take your pictures right, take your pictures yourself. Get a tripod. I will link my Amazon storefront. You can get a tripod. I have these newer lights. They have batteries. You could take them. I have a little portable handheld newer light. Like, take a tripod, Bluetooth clicker, and you're good to go. It might seem kind of weird, like, you know, going outside, taking pictures by yourself. In this day and age, everybody knows, like, what content creation, they know, like, what you're doing. Like, I remember Aaliyah's face went viral because she was in her apartment complex taking pictures with her tripod. A security guard recorded her, like, oh, look at this girl. And they're trying to, like, joke on her. And her pictures came out fine. I feel like everybody knows what content creation is, like, they see with a tripod now, it's more understandable than I'm seeing with it like back then, because like, what are you doing? And then let me touch base on this thing that I see a whole bunch of TikTok reels and TikTok and Instagram reels is this whole dark aesthetic thing. People have mixed reviews on it. People think that it's too dark, you can't see. People are being copycat, doing this, everybody else did it. But I'm not gonna lie, I did it because somebody I saw did it. Somebody I was watching on TikTok did it and they showed you how to do it. And I just think, to me, like I said, I like aesthetics. I like it when it's too dark, you have to like, you know, strain your eyes to see. But I just feel like it looks more aesthetically pleasing when it's like dark, when it's like, I feel like the image, like the video looks sharper when it's dark. A lot of people also are scared to post content because of what people think. So they think like, oh, like people I went to high school with are gonna see, or they're gonna like, laugh at me because I'm trying to take this serious, or like people, my family and friends are gonna see it and like think I'm weird, or like, oh, who are you trying to be, Jada Waiter? Like, I'm gonna flick y'all off. Forget what these people say. You're gonna make money doing what you like to do, what you love to do, while they're miserable working at 9-to-5 jobs still. Personally, I never cared about what people thought when I post my content creation. I post it on Instagram, TikTok, Facebook, YouTube, Pinterest, everywhere. Y'all won't see me on every single platform. I don't care who sees it. I posted YouTube videos. People have sent them to my grandparents, like, oh, look at her, look what she's doing. If I posted it on YouTube, which is a public platform, do you think that I care about my grandparents and my family and friends seeing it? I posted it and then shared it on different platforms for everybody to see. So no, I do not care. But there is an option on TikTok. I don't know about, I think TikTok, Instagram, I think every platform has the option when you could turn off your sync contact, sync Facebook, because if you leave those on, people who have you as a friend, people on Facebook or have your number, they're going to see your stuff because it's going to recommend your page to them. So you could turn that off and your family and friends won't just see it. They'll have to go look for it. I don't recommend it because you're a content creator. Like, you should want your platform to reach as many people as you can. You shouldn't want to hide it from anybody. But some people are not comfortable yet, and that's completely understandable. You have to break out of that though. If you want to be serious in the content creation influencer world, you have to break out of that. Like I mentioned, the comp card, if you want to be a model, I would also mention, I'm going to mention the media kit if you want to be an influencer or content creator. I'm going to go ahead and post my media kit on here so you guys can see what it looks like. This is my media kit. It has like name, pictures, insights, brands that I've worked with. You send your media kit to brands to show them like, this is me, this is what I'm about, this is what I do, this is brands I've worked with, this is the audience that I have that I can share your brand with. I would say if you're going to be trying to be working with brands, you need a media kit. If you want to be a content creator that just posts your own content and just whatever, you don't really need a media kit. But if you want to work with brands, it is pivotal for success for that, because brands need to know what they're getting into. They need to know why they should work with you. And especially if these brands are going to be paying you, they need to know your audience. What's your reach? What's your engagement? What is your audience? Do they rock with you for real? Like, where are they from? What's their age? I'm interested in food, fashion, beauty, hair, traveling, football, so like brands who fit into those categories, that is who I would reach out to or reach out to me. You know, followers does not determine your success in content creation at all. There's brands that work with micro, like people don't realize Skims, Kim Kardashian Skims, she worked with micro influencers. Like there's people on TikTok that I've seen that have less followers than me who have worked with Skims. It's because their content is good. So people focus more on the followers and you don't need to. Focus on your content. Focus on creating good content, presenting yourself well to these brands, having a good social media presence, being about your business, and these brands will work with you regardless how many followers you have. I have a collab coming up with Icon Swim. And I only have like 4,000 followers on Instagram and like 300 on TikTok. Icon Swim is a big brand, it's a well-known brand, and I'm working with them. It's because of my content, what I create, how I can show these brands off to people. My followers, of course, I live in Miami. Swimsuits are everyday wear for us. Boat days, beach days, that's an everyday thing. I created my own fragrance with this brand called Scentcraft. Like I said, I don't have a lot of followers. To have a small following my audience very much engages with me, and that matters as well. I feel like brands nowadays, like, I'm not gonna say every brand, some brands care about following because them everything is like all numbers. The people who have large followings sometimes have the worst engagement rates. When Icon Swim, when I was going back and forth corresponding with them, they still asked for a screenshot of my last three pictures in the engagement, the insights of my last three pictures. They cared about, do my followers engage with me? And since they do, I was granted that Icon Swim partnership. Oh, and by the media kit, if you are new to this, don't put your price in my media kit. Do not. Because if you have a price on your media kit, two things could happen. You could not know your prices, like not know how to price stuff well, and so you price yourself really low, and then brands take advantage of you. Like they have a budget they could offer you, but because you price yourself low, they're not going to be like, okay, well, I think you deserve more than this. No, they're going to pay you what you asked for. Two, you could price yourself high or too high above their budget, so they're just like, nah, because I can't accommodate what you're asking for. Personally, I just keep my prices off my media kit, and I correspond with the brand back and forth and negotiate prices based on our conversation and see what their budget is and what I feel like I can accommodate with their budget. But reaching out to brands. So I have a script that I use to reach out to brands where it says my name, it tells them where I'm from, what I like, what my content, like what I create content on, what I'm interested in, my niche. I don't know if it's niche or niche, whatever, you know what I'm talking about. Why I want to work with their brand, what product from their brand that I think that my followers would like and engage with. If you have a certain rate for like an Instagram picture, story, and TikTok, but their budget is low, just do like a post, or just do like a story, or just do a TikTok, like work around their budget as well. Any brand that I've reached out to, they have responded back to me, either telling me yes, like I will accept you, or no, we're not accepting any new collaborations right now, but in the future you might. But nobody has ever told me no, your following's too low. Or some people that don't have it in their budget to pay you, so they offer gifting. So like when you get a free product and you could just create your content on that free product. If you are new to the game, I would say gifting is definitely a good way to get yourself out there, to get familiar with creating content. Personally, I would say put your email in your Instagram bio and all your bios, so I can actually write it out in your bio. I read it in a book somewhere, an influencer book somewhere, just makes things better. But I wouldn't say go ahead and accept every single brand that reaches out to you, just because if things don't align with you and how you work and how you create things in your niche, I would say don't just do it just to have the sake of a collaboration. So I also am now on the Amazon influencer side. So I just opened up my storefront with Amazon. I will link that down below. So that I had to go ahead and apply for that. People have applied and got denied. I really don't know their criteria. People who have more followers than me have applied and got denied. I don't know what they're looking for, how they go ahead and base it on. I know that I applied on my first time and I got approved. Some people have applied multiple times and gotten denied. Later on, I approved. I don't know how it goes. Make like little collections like shoes, tops, bottom, purses, accessories, hair, household goods, and like people click on your link and go to your section, click on what they like, they purchase it, and you get a commission off of that. Just saying that you're an Amazon influencer, it sounds good. Like, it makes you look good. And Amazon actually just had a brunch in California. They flew people out from all over to California for a Black influencer Amazon brunch. So many opportunities with this whole influencer thing. Like, a flight to California, they paid for stay, travel, food, all that, like, just for you creating content and being an influencer. Like, the higher you get up, they also start sending you gifts. So like people think the word influencer is cringe and think content creation is cringe. I'm telling you, it is not. It can change lives. I have a homeboy who is a content creator, and he has been going up on content creation. He started off making videos of him just trying out restaurants, and now he has deals with like McDonald's, a whole bunch of restaurants. A way to market yourself if you have a low following count like me, like I said, the media kit would be your best friend because it makes you look more serious about your craft. So if you guys like this whole like series and like these kind of videos, I can also make a video how to create a media kit or to put on your media kit. I can also give you some scripts of how to reach out to brands and how to market yourself to brands. When it comes to content creation and working with brands, I would say, like I said, email. You can Google company and Google their PR, or just go to their Instagram and DM them. Those are ways you can reach out. Aspire is a good site that you can use. They have a lot of paid and gifted collaborations. You can select if you only want to do paid ones, you can select that as well, enter your prices or negotiate your prices with them. Aspire has very popular brands, like they have L'Oreal, Joa Beauty, Dyson, HelloFresh, Keurig, Pinterest, Lifetime, Check. They have very, very, very big brands on there that do paid collaborations, as well as sometimes they only do gifted collaborations. So when you first start off with Aspire though, you can only do 5 collaborations a month until a brand leaves a review on your content, like on your content you created. Once you get a 4 or 5 star review, then you can do unlimited collaborations a month. An app that I started working with is Octoly. But they only do gifted collaboration, so it's only things that they can gift you, and you create your content based off of that gift. I just received a package from them as well, a hairbrush straightener that I got for free. Like these, and some of these gifts are like, they go for like hundreds of dollars, and I get them for free just to create content with. I upload my media kit and companies can look on that. I click on what I want, like, oh, I want this, and they look at my page, my media kit, and decide, yes, I'm gonna send this to her, or no, I'm not going to. Lenny Kravitz has a toothpaste coming out that I was just going to, I use toothpaste every day, so I was going to create content on that, and I actually was denied because, I don't know, it doesn't tell you why you were denied, but, so yeah, like I said, I don't get every single thing that I submit for. Alright, so yeah, that is the end of this video. Like I said, this is gonna be real, raw, uncut. Content road to content creator, influencer, model. I give you guys tips that I have used to help me get started on this journey. Hopefully these tips can help you as well. So yeah, just don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and I will see you guys in the next video.